I wear black and white today for a special reason. We've arrived. GameStop. Why am I still filming the front of this GameStop store? Well, I teleported. And I got both games and a free Keldeo poster. Amazing. With the release of Black and White 2, the release of a new event came out, the Genesects event, over Wi-Fi, on Black 2 and White 2. My goal is to get 4 of them before November 12th when it ends, and in order to do that I have to beat through the first gym on White 3 times, because I already have one from Black version too. Basically I have to download it through Mystery Gift and then beat the first gym and trade it over to Black and White. And I'm about to open up White 2. It's October 16th today. Kind of getting a late start on this. But I'm really enjoying the game so far. And I think we're going to try and obtain the other Genesects. Let's see how long this takes. Let's do this. Second Genesect has been traded to Black. I'm about to restart White 2 again. It's Saturday morning, October 20th. And it looks really nice outside today, so I think I'm going to knock this one out by going on a walk. Deleting all the old save data from the old game. Pretty freaking amazing outside right now. The sun is out, and it's not too hot or not too cold, especially for this time of year. And in a minute, I'm about to download Genesect again, after all this deletes. Outside, Wi-Fi. It's pretty amazing. And I have received Genesect. and therefore I can begin my game.
Very strong sunlight overhead. I blame Groudon's drought. Or maybe a Ninetales, since it can learn drought now.
I was right.
Wow.
Unless I'm playing through the beginning of a Pokemon game, it takes me a while to really realize how slow the walking actually is before you get the running shoes. It makes me really appreciate that mechanic. But I guess my walking is just about the same speed.
Yeah.
Scenic point. It's also a nice sunny spot where I can film. I've decided that the optimal Pokemon to choose at the beginning is Tepig for speedrunning, due to learning Ember, which is a powerful move so early. Oh, look at that lookout point. It's better than that one because there's a mountain. I wish we had mountains around here. Tepig, battle scene off, and tech speed super fast. It will really, like, aid you along the way and cut your time at least in a fourth. I got the running shoes. No more lethargic pain.
I guess I used my running shoes too, and now I'm home from the walk. I didn't really accomplish too much. But this is the first time I've ever used the highest brightness setting on the DS. I mean 3DS, and it's crazy. Didn't know it could be like this vibrant and colorful. But yeah. Oh, now I learned Ember, I'm pretty sure.
Yeah!
Now I can like blast through this really easily and quickly. Even though I'm nowhere near the first gym, I might as well go ahead and get the Genesect. Boom. Now let's see what this one looks like. Nature and whatnot. Modest. Very nice.
I've decided that Tepig is actually the worst choice, because it is very often raining in these areas at the beginning of the game,
unlike in real life right now.
And Ember almost does nothing. Like, watch how much damage it does to this. Wow. This was a pretty darn good choice the first time, darn it, because it wasn't raining. But Tackle still does decent damage.
Finally lazily beat Sharon, and I got the Sea Gear, which means I now finally can trade over Genesect number 3 to Black. One more left to go. Making the trade between White 2 and Black 1. I'm just going to transfer them all to Black for convenience. And that way I can start on the next one. Hooray!
Alright, so today is Halloween. I'm going to resume this Genesect quest. Wait, where's the game? I left it right here on the table. I don't know where it is. It's Marth. I haven't seen you since last Christmas when I captured Kyurem. You grew a beard. Alright, so where do you know where the game is, or circling. It's a really long beard. Didn't know someone could grow that in a year. Conversational as usual. Let's observe his behavioral patterns. At every Stars and Stripes light, he's doing something with his leg. I'm not sure this will contribute to me finding White 2 to continue the Genesect quest. Well, he finally finished the circling thing, and it's been about 10 minutes now. And now he's led me here, and he's just standing at this gate with preparation. Is it in the woods? Do you want me to follow you? Want me to follow you? Oh, he lost his hat. Those look like dangerous woods. He has the game. I lost the game, but now it's found. You lost the game.
Thank you, mysterious stranger.
Using my sorcery powers, I will delete this save file on Pokemon White 2. Mwahahaha! Sorcery successful.
Okay, now to not be completely ridiculous.
Hey guys, guess what? I'm out of school today. So I can finally get Genesect number 4.
I'm at the lake right now. It's a nice and calm lake. I chose Snivy.
Pinwheel Forest.
Dragon Spiral Tower.
So far my impression on Snivy is that it has a pretty good physical attack set. It learns Vine Whip early on, which means it can easily take out a lot of the water types that you encounter early on in the game. So it's still a decent choice. Really didn't expect it to be, but I guess it's because I'm so used to Final Form Superior, and the one on White 1 that I had didn't have a good nature for attack or anything. I'm gonna completely disregard this sign, because who knows what hidden hollows can be found in the trees. Huge bird up there. Probably a heron or an egret of some sort. And there's a turtle! Is it a wild Squirtle? Look, its shell is blue and everything. And looky here now. Blue skies. Very nice. Refreshing compared to the clouds earlier. Heading back down the road, it is evident that the Squirtle has finally crossed the road. He's no longer where he was. Now I'm about to finish off against Sharon, because I just beat the two apprentice trainers in his gym. And then I ought to be able to be done with this quest.
Alright, I'm home, making bagel bites, because they're good.
And my DS is in my pocket. Okay. Basically, Snivy's underleveled, level 14, to go against Sharon right now. So what I'm doing is basically leveling it up to level 15, because I think that'll probably be able to take out his lily pup before it uses workup tackle. We've just reached level 15, finally. And the bagel bites are officially finished. Aren't they lovely looking? Now that I have enough power to beat the first gym, and then trade over Genesect, I will celebrate with pizza. The pizza quickly disappeared. But now I can trade over the last Genesect. Well, first I actually have to download the last Genesect.
Final Genesect has been received. Righteous. Yeah, I'm gonna have to choose another Pokemon to trade over. I might just trade over one of these eggs. But yeah, we're about to make the final trade, and then from then on, we'll be done with the Technoblast operation.
Now that I have traded over the fourth Genesect, I can mark... I didn't mark the third one on the sheet. But I can now mark that those two are done, and the operation to get at least 4 before November 12th is complete. And that means I can move on to my next order of business, which involves a full run-through of Pokemon White 2 on video in a series. It's gonna have an interesting twist, though. And in order to see that twist, you'll just have to wait until next time.